What is up, everyone? Welcome to Investing Club. In this video, we're going to be talking about NIO stock and if they are a good buy today based on the prices they're currently trading at and what you can expect from this company in the future. So NIO stock has been on a complete tear in the past couple of months. They hit their low around March 20th, and since then they're up 379%. So that is a huge run up for a stock like NIO. So first, a quick overview. NIO is an electric car company that makes electric vehicles in China. So we can take a look at some of their cars, and they do look pretty cool. I'm liking what I see. They have some pretty interesting concepts and designs, and I think they have the potential to bring the EV market to China. So now let's dive a little deeper into the fundamentals to see what's really going on, why NIO stock prices went up so much in the past couple of months, and if this can continue. Now, just a few weeks ago, NIO released their quarter one earnings, and the numbers that came out were absolutely awful. As everyone expected, vehicle sales down, a decrease of 18.2%. You see vehicle margin down again, total revenues down 15.9%. from the same quarter last year. Gross margin down, loss from operations was bigger than it was in the previous year. Net loss even worse than last year. Everything that this company should be doing, more sales, more vehicle deliveries, they didn't do. So why, despite this awful report, have NIO shares jumped up almost 380%? And it is due to the massive funding that NIO just received that basically ensured that they would stay alive at least for the foreseeable future. Now, last week, NIO announced that they entered a capital partnership with the government. The local government in China took a stake in NIO. And this is crazy because in the US, you would never see this happening. You'd never see the government taking a stake in an individual company. But these days, you never know with what the Federal Reserve has been doing. Maybe this is something they'll get to. But anyway, this is happening in China where the government takes stakes in companies. And that happened where the local government took a stake in NIO, and they injected the company with a ton of cash. Those investors are going to invest $7 billion in cash into NIO, and this deal will take place in the second quarter of 2020, which we're in right now. So this is happening right now. And this is huge news for NIO stock. NIO's cash and liquidity position before this was horrible. They had no liquidity, and it wasn't very certain if they were going to make it out of this situation alive. Back at the end of 2019, beginning of 2020, this company was trading at under $2 a share, and that's because there were huge concerns on if this company was even going to make it. They were running so low on cash that it wasn't clear if they were even going to make it through the next few months, even before the whole economic shutdown happens. So throw that in, and this deal was a real lifesaver for NIO. In addition, we also see Tencent upping their stake. If you don't know, Tencent is the biggest social media company in China, and they have a pretty big stake in NIO. They own around 15% of the entire company. So that is good news for NIO shareholders that this company is now backed by one of the largest corporations in China, as well as the local government. So I think part of this run-up is the excitement that with all this backing, NIO is not going to be allowed to fail. The government has a stake in NIO. They're obviously not going to let them fail. And so I think that's a fair point. I also don't think they would let them fail at this point. But I think a lot of investors that are jumping into the stock right now are not taking into account the huge risks with this company. And I'm going to point some of them out to you in this video. The thing that's about to happen with NIO is a huge amount of dilution with this new partnership that they have with the government. And they're going to issue new equity to pay off some of their debt for this deal. They're going to offer 60 million ADS shares. And the ADS shares are what you're buying if you're in the United States. If you're in the US and you buy NIO stock, this is what you're buying, the American depository shares. And we can take a quick look at NIO's shares outstanding. They have around 1 billion shares outstanding. And so they're issuing 60 million shares right now. And that is a very big amount of dilution that this company is about to go through. And this was a smart move by NIO because they see the stock price run up and they say, when the stock price is so high, it's gone up 300%. They say, hey, let's issue shares right now. We can get more money from the shares we issue when it's up 3 times compared to where it was a couple of months ago under $2 a share. So this was a good move for NIO, and it was something they had to do. NIO had so much debt and they had so many problems with liquidity, they had to convert some of that debt to equity. While that will save them in the short term, long term that has some implications that is really harmful for shareholders. In the long run, equity is more expensive than debt. So while issuing equity to help pay down their debt right now will certainly help them, it's going to hurt them in the long run. And the biggest problem I see is that this is likely to keep happening in the future. NIO still has $1.5 billion in debt, and they have only $350 million in cash. So this share dilution is likely not stopping anytime soon. They're going to have to continue to do this to keep paying off their debt. And while it looks like nothing's really happening, it looks like the debt's going down, and nothing's really happening besides the share count going up, the reality is this will have a huge impact for numbers like earnings per share and revenue per share And so that's probably the biggest concern with me with NIO stock. The dilution that's coming with this company is going to be huge. So now let's actually talk about some of the things I like about NIO stock, because there are some things I like about this company, and I think they are starting to head in the right direction. So what the management said in their quarter one earnings call is that they expect gross margins to become profitable in this quarter. In the second quarter, they expect gross margins to be at around 3%. And this is a huge difference from where we've seen in the last few quarters, where it's negative 10%, negative 15% hovering around there. So if we could actually see positive gross margins from this company, that would definitely be a step in the right direction. Here are the estimates for sales. They are expected to keep going up at an exponential rate with these high growth companies. This is usually the chart that you're going to see where it just goes up every year more and more. And so that's good news. With NIO, you have to see those revenues increasing, because that's what everyone's investing in. This is a growth story. And so you have to see growth like this to make a company like NIO worth investing in. And so here is estimates on NIO's earnings per share. And I would put some caution on this chart, because this assumes that they do everything perfectly, that the management executes, does what they need to do, and everything goes right for this company. And if that did happen by 2025, we could see earnings per share of around $6 or $7 per share. And so if that did happen, then the price right now at around $11 is probably a steal for NIO stock. Again, I'm not sure how convinced I am that this amount of earnings growth will come to fruition in a short amount of time, but that is the kind of upside with this company if you really believe that they're going to become the dominant EV player in China. So lastly, let's take a look at the valuation that NIO is currently trading at and see how it compares to other electric vehicle makers. So right now, NIO isn't making a profit, so we're going to have to look at something like price to sales to attempt to put a value on NIO. So right now the price of sales is sitting at 8.76, and that definitely is a high, even for a high growth company like NIO, but we can see how it compares to some other companies. So first we can compare it to a company like Tesla, since that is the company most people compare NIO to. And Tesla is at a price of sales of, again, around 9.05. So NIO is valued very similar to how Tesla is at the moment. We could also look at stocks like Nikola, which has also been getting a lot of hype lately, and their price to sales is 48,000, so that's not really going to help us much there. We could look at a company like Workhorse, which again is one that's getting a lot of hype. I know they're an electric vehicle company. Their price to sales is 11,000, so that's not going to help. So basically what I'm seeing right now is NIO is being valued the same way that Tesla is right now. And so if you're someone that invests in Tesla and you think Tesla, you know, if you think there's upside for Tesla at the prices they're currently at, you'd probably think there's similar upside for a company like NIO at their current valuation. So that's pretty much my analysis for a company like NIO. Again, the biggest plus with this company right now is that they have funding from the government, and the biggest downside is the dilution that's going to come to their shares and how that's going to impact their future earnings. And so am I investing in the stock? No, I am not investing in NIO stock, just because if you watch the channel, you know, this isn't the type of company I invest in. A little too speculative for me. Again, it could turn into a good play if they become profitable and we see consistent growth from them, then maybe I would take a look at them. But I always like to wait to see that happen first before I jump in and invest. NIO does have some interesting upside if things work out well for them. But in my opinion, there's a lot of risk and a ton of things that could go wrong with this company that people, I don't think, are pricing into the stock price right now. Just one example of that risk is that this is a smaller Chinese company. And so there's been a lot of issues with Chinese companies in the past. You just look at Luckin Coffee a couple of months ago, what they went through. Their stock is now down around 95%. So obviously not every Chinese company is doing that, but that is a concern to have, where Chinese companies don't have to face the same scrutiny in their accounting as American companies do. So a lot of them are going to have an incentive to make their numbers look better than they really are. And so that's always something to have in the back of your head, which is another reason why I wouldn't invest in a stock like NIO. So that's it for this analysis. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you bought NIO. Let me know if you made money on NIO in the past couple of days. If you caught the trend early, you saw all these EV stocks going up and you said, hey, let's jump in NIO. And if you're planning on holding long-term, or if you're just going to sell it for a quick profit. This is just my opinion. I am not a financial advisor. This isn't financial advice. So don't buy NIO based on watching this video. It is just my opinion. And as always, I could be wrong. So that's it for the video. If you liked it, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next video.